Hi, my name is Obukhova Anna. I'm agile coach and former biologist, and I would like to invite you to my course, High Performance Agile Teams, that will be in Riga, 18th and 19th of June. This course is about what makes our brain to perform better. And usually we can think about what happens in our brains, but we also need to put this approach to others. How we can change the process so our teams work better, to be more engaged, to be more motivated. And we don't have carrot or stick. Or even if we have, they usually do not work. They don't work anymore for about more than 20 years now. So we'll try to find a novel approach that is based on neuroleadership, on knowledge how our brain works inside and how the processes outside and how we behave, how we talk with people, how we give feedback, how we set tasks can affect what happens in the brain and can affect how people perform. There is a model, so there is a framework consisting of six different things, and these things, there are a lot of practices. So overall there are more than 40, so 42 practices that we have that combined together can create a framework and the environment where your team can perform better. So one of these elements is about external environment, how we define processes. Another is internal environment, what happens inside our brain and how the brain works. Then we will talk about how we think about setting tasks, how the goals are working, how we can set goals so people really want to achieve them. Then the next one is about understanding and authorizing results. So we understand, we did that, I did that. Yeah, and it's interesting. And there is a lot of hormonal support that supports when we understand that, okay, I've reached this goal, I'm really happy about that. And this happiness creates anticipation that next step will give us more energy, more joy, more understanding that, oh, okay, I can do that. And the next one is freedom of choice. If we don't give people freedom of choice, we give them perfect tasks, they understand what they've done, but they have no choice to say no to the task or have no choice to choose the task they want to do. The whole setting inside our brain about motivation doesn't work. And the last and the central thing of this framework is knowing yourself. We are fantastically different. We are awesome. Everything is really interesting, and there will be several things that we will understand. How much energy we have? What is our nervous system type? What is our leadership profile? What is our type of game? What types of activities do not drain our energy? And what type of activities do drain our energy? So all these type of things that we will learn about ourselves, there will be a lot of practice. And then you can move these things to your team and describe it to your people and use these things to your team as well. And one thing that will be like described throughout the whole model, what we can do if the team has not enough energy. It can be real burnout, it can be just not enough energy to the role or the type of activities that you have in your team. So what we can do that? So what are the stages, how you can identify how processes and practices change when you understand when your team is tired? This is very important to the performance as well, because tired team doesn't give you perfect performance and so on. So all these things, powered by the knowledge how the brain works, powered with the agile practices, how this works together, what is your type, what is your preferred type of work, and how you can apply this to your team. And you even not always can tell this to your team. And these practices work even if you do them without telling anyone that you are doing them. Would be happy to see you, high performance agile teams, 18th and 19th of June, Riga. See you.